software class. So we have been discussing about the form factor on resistance. This is due to the use of a flat plate formula for the representation of the frictional resistance coefficient, such as the ITDC formula, which we normally use to find out the frictional resistance coefficient of ship and model. Since this formula, this type of formula, they have been evolved based on the experiments carried out using flat plate. The three-dimensional form of the form effect on the resistance, frictional resistance or viscous resistance, is not taken care of in this formula. So the ship and or model, which is having a three-dimensional form, will have a hydrodynamic variations in the flow around it and subsequently on the frictional resistance. So that difference in the flow pattern between the flat plate and the ship should be taken into account, and that is what you call the form factor. And we have already gone through the method suggested by Prahaska in the determination of form factor. This we have already discussed. So these are the things we have seen: representation of the wave making resistance as V^6 or Foot number power raised to 6, and subsequently the wave resistance coefficient will be proportional to Foot number raised to 4. So these things we have already discussed. And finally we arrived at the equation expression, that this CT by CFO, I think it is represented here. This CT is equal to 1 plus K into CFO plus ZW, which is represented by a function of Froude number raised to 4. So this is the equation which represents a straight line if you plot this against this, with this giving as the intersection of the straight line. So which is shown in the next diagram. You can see that if you plot this quantity, that is CT by CF, against this quantity, so you get the equation representing that of a straight line, y is equal to mx plus c form, and where the c is represented by the 1 plus k, which shows that this is the intersection point. So what you do is, you perform experiments on the model for very low speed, and where the wave making effect is insignificant. So it is mainly due to the viscous effect, the resistance, and that viscous resistance you plot it here using this. The CT is a total resistance coefficient divided by the frictional resistance coefficient obtained from ITDC formula. So you have this ratio, and then you plot it against this value, that is the Froude number power 4 divided by the frictional resistance coefficient obtained from ITDC formula. So then you get the red points here. These are the points which come from the model test, and to that point you fit a straight line. You can see that it is almost following the patterns, following a straight line, and this straight line is represented by this equation, and from which the intersection you get, that is 1 plus k is obtained from this. So here in this case it is coming to almost 1.15. That is 1 plus k, or k, the form factor is equal to, form fraction is equal to 0.15. So that is how it is estimated through experiments. So the model has to be operated at very low speed where the wave making effect is insignificant. So the total resistance is due to the viscous effect. Okay, these points also we have seen that when the so here the uncertainty of measuring resistance at very low speed is relatively large, because the values, resistance value is very small. So when you try to measure a small value, even a slight deviation in the measurement leads to a large error. So one has to be very careful. So that is why it says that it is an uncertainty in measurement of resistance at low speed. So this means that it is difficult to determine the run-in point. We have already discussed the resistance curve, where is a run-in point, which shows that. So I think I have already explained that the run-in point. If you draw the CT against, sorry, Reynolds number, I just put the fruit number. Okay, fruit number, you see the resistance is goes like this and then increases like this. So this is the, this is a run-in point. So this we have already discussed when we discuss about the Hughes method for the prediction of resistance from model test. So it is difficult to determine the run-in point because that's a region with having a this uncertainty, because you have to operate the model at very low fruit number. So for Fuller form, this plot is a concave curvature. We see in the next slide when you plot these values, you can see that when the form is full, it comes a concave. It's not a straight line. When the Fuller form ships like tankers and bulk carriers, when you consider the wave making resistance is high, and hence wave making resistance generally represented is proportional to V^6. That may not hold strictly good for Fuller form ships. So you have to put a higher power. So that means you have to put the CW is a function of or is proportional to, normally we put Fn^4, but that power of 4 is not sufficient for ships having Fuller form. So it is advised to give the power between 4 and 6. That is what it means. So it's better to use a power for Fn between 4 and 6 instead of 4. So if you are having testing a tanker ship or a bulk carrier or any full form ships, maybe a barge, so what you do is you use the relation where you used, I think this relation here, in place of 4 you use 5 or 6. Otherwise, if you don't use it, then you get this curve. So if you use 5 or 6 appropriate power for that, then you get a straight line and easy representation of the resistance, and then to find out the form factor. So we have seen Hughes method for prediction, and ITTC 1957 method is the next method which is used for the prediction of ship resistance from the model test data. So later it has been revised as ITTC 1978, which follows this one. So the model test, the model resistance, the total resistance coefficient of the model CTM, you know that it is represented by total resistance of the model divided by half rho m, that is freshwater density, model's velocity square into surface weighted surface area of the model. So this gives the total resistance coefficient of the model, and we know that total resistance coefficient of the model is represented as a summation of frictional resistance and also residual resistance. This is actually m. So ITTC formula gives the frictional resistance CFM based on the plate flat plate experiment. So this expression is given as 0.075 divided by log RNM minus 2 the whole square. This is the expression used. So here the you specifically note that the Reynolds number used here is that of the model. So model Reynolds number. So you find out this quantity from the ITTC formula, and then you can substitute it here so that you will get CRM is equal to CTM minus CFM. That is what is there. CRM is equal to CTM minus CFM, because CFM is known now from this expression. So from which CTM is already measured, RTM measured, total resistance of the model measured, you know these parameters. So total resistance coefficient is also known. So you know these two quantities, CTM is known, CFM known. So you can find out what is CRM, which is given by this relation. And we already know that it follows the fruit assumption. The test is done based on the fruit assumption, that is the fruit number of the ship is equal to the fruit number of the model. So that is the one which you are tallying, and based on which you know the model speed is equal to ship speed divided by square root of the scale used. So under that condition you see CRS is equal to CRM. The residual resistance coefficient of the ship and model are same, since it's satisfying the fruit number. So the total resistance coefficient of the ship is equal to CFS, that is frictional resistance of the ship, minus CRS, and that is equal to CFS plus ZRM, because both are same. So you just this is plus. This I think there's a mistake there. Should be plus. So here the CFS you get again from IDDC formula. Same thing. The only difference is use the Reynolds number of the ship, not the Reynolds number of the model. So here you use the Reynolds number of the ship, you get CFS, and this CFS value is used here, and CRM equals CRS, which is obtained from the model test. You are substituting here, and from here you will get this, the total value, that is CTS. So what you get is you have estimated CTS, that is equal to CFS value. Then for the model you have to give an allowance called the model ship correlation allowance. Model ship correlation allowance is allowance given to take into account the discrepancy of the surface roughness between the model and ship. The ship model is made of any, you know, fiber glass or wax models and all, very smooth, whereas the ship surface is not so smooth. So there is a variation in the roughness. There are various reasons which we discuss in the preliminary classes, what's the roughness causes, that is the weld joints, deformation of plate, there are many other causes which adds to texture of paints. So many reasons which contribute to the increase in roughness for this ship, which is not accounted or which is not scaled down to that of the model. So that difference in roughness increases the resistance of the ship. So that difference, which you call the model ship correlation allowance, which is normally given as this value, is substituted here. So you get the total resistance coefficient for the, then you multiply the total resistance coefficient by the ship parameters, including the seawater density, ship velocity square, and ship wetter surface area. So then you get the total, this is RTS, total resistance of the ship. So that is the procedure adopted in IDDC 1957 method for the prediction of ship resistance from the model test data. So here you might have noticed that the form factor has been not considered in IDDC 1957 model. The effect of form has been ignored. So here when it comes to this has been noticed and the difference has been understood and accepted by IDDC and came out in 1978 with a prediction method, modified prediction method for the ship resistance from model test. So here what it does is CTS is equal to 1 plus K into CFS plus CR plus CA plus CAA. What are these quantities? K, 1 plus K is a form factor, CFS is IDDC 1957 gave that model for frictional resistance expression, CR the residual resistance, which is already resistance, CR is a coefficient how it is measured. Then this is a model ship correlation allowance for roughness, and this one is the air resistance. So that is also taken consideration in the next. So here that is all explained, form factor, K is a form factor, CFS coming from IDDC 1957 expression, CR we have already seen from the model. So here the CR will be CTM minus 1 plus K into CFM. It is not just in the previous one, in 57 expression you had CR is equal to CTM minus CFM, but here the form factor is coming into effect. So the form factor effect is also considered in the 1978 IDDC performance prediction method. So CFM is equal to CF of models as per IDDC, again same thing. CA roughness, the expression given is this one, CA is equal to given by this expression, where KS is the, you know, the surface is not going to be an even surface, it is a rough surface. So if you measure it microscopic level, you will see that it is totally a random surface, it is not a, so then what you do is you measure it, you map it, then you analyze it and find out what is the mean apparent amplitude of the surface roughness for a over a 50 mm wave length. So that is how the value has been used. So unfortunately, maybe during the design or estimation side of resistance, you don't have the information about the roughness of the ship into the details. So you don't have a, you know, the picture or graph representing the roughness. So you won't be able to use this information from the actual surface. What you do is, if you don't have this information, then use this 150 into 10 power minus 6 KS. So use this, you put it here, LWL, you know, length of water line. So you get what is CA, and you use it, that value, instead of putting 0.0004, that is the value normally we used. Even now also we use that zero, you can see that this is the value we use. So maybe it's more accurate if you know the information about roughness, use this formula for CA. So C double A, this is representing the air resistance coefficient. You know, when the ship is moving, air is flowing opposite to that, and there will be resistance induced by the air media, flow of air. So that is accounted by here, this expression. This is AVT divided by S. AVT is a projected frontal area. That means, if the ship is, I have already explained that in one of the previous classes, when the ship is moving forward, so the blocking area, you take the transverse area, wind, the air is flowing in the opposite direction. So the transverse area, the above water portion of that, of the ship is taken, it is equal to AVT. It is a projected front area of the ship above water line. Yes, same wetter surface of the hull. Then for ships with bilge keel, so you have, if once you know the ship geometry, you can find out what is AVT and also what is wetter surface. You substitute in this, you get CAA, that is it. So you know, in these calculations, so you may not have included the wetter surface, the appendages like bilge keel or fins or whatever it may be. So you don't have. So what you do is, how do you take into account the effect of bilge keel? Bilge keel is you know, deeply submerged. It is at the bilge position of the ship. So the wave making effect is insignificant because it's deeply submerged. It's, that's about near to the bottom of the ship. So the frictional effect is small. So on the resistance. So what you do is, so you just consider the same the frictional aspect, that is 1 plus k into CFS plus CA. This you know already for the Behel model without the bilge keel. So what you do is, you multiply, when you multiply you take the ratio of the total wetter surface area, that is, this is the wetter surface area of the ship plus wetter surface area of the bilge keel, then divided by wetter. So that ratio will take care of the variation in the appendage. So that is what is considered here, and then you have the residual resistance coefficient and air resistance coefficient. So putting all this together, you get the total resistance coefficient, then you multiply it by half rho SV square of the ship, then you get the total resistance for the ship. So that is the prediction suggested in the 1978 IDTC method. So IDTC recommends the use of form factor for better representation of shipment. That is what you have seen, 1978 method is shown compared to IDTC 57 method. Prakaska's method has been recommended. We have seen the Prakaska's method for the prediction of form factor. IDTC also recommends the same thing. So in Prakaska's method, you know, you run the model at very low Froude number also. The data obtained at very low Froude number, then you have plotted CT by CFO against Fn raised to 4 by CFO. Then you got a straight line, you take the intersection of that, that is 1 plus k. So that is the form factor, that is a procedure adopted by Prakaska. If the vessel is full of foam, like tanker or bulk area or barges and all that, so then instead of plotting the abscissa Fn raised to 4 by CFO, you put Fn raised to 5 or maybe Fn raised to 6 by FO, then you get the straight line for that. Prakaska's method for form factor is recommended. Then resistance usually at low speed, here it says if it is too low Reynolds number, then measurement become very difficult, or it is too in the laminar region. So it generally recommended is this region, usually you go but very low Froude number, in this lower of this range to get the to estimate the form factor. So for ships with varying submerged bulbous bow, the effect of wave making resistance prediction is not convincing. So that means partly submerged bulbous bow. So if you design the bulbous bow and if it's partly submerged, okay, the estimation of wave breaking resistance it's not convincing because of the the part of it and wave creation. Bulbous bow is provided for reducing a wave breaking resistance, and I've already discussed when we discuss about the bulbous bow effect. So one of the aspects, second aspect of bulbous bow is to it creates a wave system which will destructively interfere with the ship wave system and thus bring down the resultant wave system and hence reduce the wave making resistance. So two counts, the two effects for bulbous bow. So if the bulbous bow generally it submerged condition you consider subsurface, and if it's partly submerged, that is part above the water, then you have problem in predicting it. So instead of the determining K on the base of Prakashka's, yeah, that's right. Instead of using a power 4 here and constants and all that, this is a general expression put forward by IDTC. So the N and other coefficients C and all these, it varies with respect to the type of ship. So the values of N are determined by the least square approximation of the measured data. So you have measured data and fix it, then you find out what are the values of this. So you fit an equation to the data, you will find what is the N, what is C and what is K and all that. So in 1978, ITTC 1978 method, the same thing which is put in a graphical form. What you have is, you have the baseline here, that is ITTC 1957 CF formula, this one, this is which is depending on Reynolds number. So you plot this CF or value in this axis and against the Reynolds number. So you get this curve, this dotted line over here, this is given by the ITTC 1957 formula. Now what you do is, you do the experiments for different fruit number, you get values. You can see here fruit number very low, fruit number increases. So this is the CT curve for the model. So you do the model, you get to measure the total resistance of the model divided by half rho SV square of the model. So you get CT of the model. So for different fruit number, you get the values, you plot it. And here this region, this is a run-in point which I said, this is a run-in point. So this region one has to be very careful, get the this point more close and more accurate so that the form factor estimation become reliable. So now what you do is, you multiply this, you have the baseline, you multiply it by 1.1, 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, like you draw lines along with that throughout. So you just draw the lines. Okay, and now you have this value, this is CF value from ITTC, this is CF value from ITTC into 1.1, this is CF value into of ITTC into 1.2, like that. So you get for a range of Reynolds number, you get these curves. Now you know the run-in point here, it is coming like this. So you can see that that run-in point is coinciding with the red dotted line here. You can see the red dotted line. So run-in point coincides with this line, and hence this value that is that lies between 1.1 and 1.2 line. So that interpolated, you see that that is a form factor, that is maybe 1.12 or 1.13, that is the value you are getting there. So that is a form factor you get. So here you can see that this curve here, that represents the actually the K factor. So if this is this value up to this red line, so you extended that line even to the ship side. Reynolds number of ship is very high, so ship operates in this region and the model operates at low Reynolds number in this region. Usually this is a huge number, so you put a logarithmic scale in the x axis, isn't it? So that is what is done here. So here what you do is, so you have this red line. So you know the form factor of the model and form factor of the ship remains same. So you based on red line. So now you estimate the CFS from the IDDC formula, where you put Reynolds number of the ship and then you get a CFS, then you have the form factor, then you get the total viscous effect, and over which you know CRM is same as CRS, so you put the CRS value over that, so you get the point here for the different Froude number. Okay, so here for each Froude number you have CRS value, and here also you put that same value, so you get this curve, that is for the smooth hull of ship. Now you know that the ship surface is different, is more rough, so you give the CA allowance here, so this so you get allowance for CA, you get this curve here, this is the curve for the, so this is a CTS of the ship. So this is a prediction method proposed by ITTC 1978. You find out the model, you test the model, you find out the CT of the model, then you get this curve for different Froude number, then you have the CF coming from 1957 ITTC formula, you generate curves multiplying by 1.1, 1.2 like that, you generate the curves, then you know, you find out what is the run in point here, that run in point shows that that is a region having no viscous, no wave making effect, so that is purely viscous, so that run in point you can see it is coinciding with some of the line parallel to already drawn line. So then you find out what is the form factor by interpolating that. The same line continues here, the form factor of the ship and model remains same. So here you just come down over to the ship region and then you put the form factor and also the CF is already there. So from there you put CRS which is and CRM which is equal to CRS, and that value you get this resistance curve. And then you apply the correction for roughness, that is model ship correlation allowance, then you get the total resistance of the ship. So that is a prediction method adopted by ITTC 1978 method. So that is the method we also follow in our drawing tank. So we are following this procedure. Okay, I just want to see the tests are done. We have the facility here in IIT Madras, and the towing tank we do undertake different projects and tests and all that. And this test, you can see that it's one of the video of a river sea vessel. It is a vessel which is expected to operate, meant for operation in river and also to the sea. So this gives, you can see this test gives not only resistance, it also gives the pattern of wave around the vessel. You can see that the pattern of wave around the vessel. So if from the video or from the observation, if you find that the wave is going to be high and the wave making resistance is high, you will get an information which part of the ship is creating more wave and where you need attention to modify the form that region so that wave making resistance can be brought down. So this gives the total resistance and also gives information about the flow characteristics around that, around the vessel, and the same model will be subsequently used for self propulsion test and flow line test and all that. So this is another type which is a 1000 ton oil barge, it is another project. You can see that effect of bulb here, we have studied the effect of different types of bulb, that is bulb parameters varied and found the effect of resistance on the vessel due to the change in the bulbous bow parameters. So what would be the effect? This is a new generation fishing vessel which is being planned, and so this is normally the fishing vessels are a displacement type, but here this proposal is to come up with a semi displacement or semi planing vessel. So here the intention is that the vessel which can reach from the fishing harbor to the fishing ground faster, because the vessel which reaches fast or first get more catch. So you want to have the vessel to have high speed. So what do you do is the fishing school is identified, maybe by aerial survey or maybe from satellite information, that is that information that is identified, that fish school is available at such and such location, so much latitude, longitude and all that. So then that information is fed to the fishing harbor where the fishing vessels operate. So once that information is obtained, information passed on to the fishing vessel operators, they put the vessel to operation. So the vessel which reaches the fishing ground first will have more chance of getting more catch. So this intention is for that, you go for a semi-plane vessel, so it move faster and reaches the fishing ground faster. But thing is, when it come back, it is loaded with fish. So that time it's difficult to plane. So while coming back, you can take little more time. Doesn't matter because already the fish is with you, with the ship. So it doesn't matter. So it takes the fish and come in a normal displacement and lower speed. So this is to study the effect of the vessel for different speeds and you know how it performs in different condition. You can see that the steppings here, which gives actually the arresting the spray of the water when it's moving at a high speed. And this also here we have checked the rigid inflatable boat rib vessel. You can see that how it's tested. It's also done in our tank, which is a planing one. Obviously, it is a high speed vessel. So this you can see is a rigid inflatable boat, and you can see the planing effect. How it planes, is planing sufficiently, and what would be the position of center of gravity on the planing and all that. These effects are studied during this. It's also related. You measure the resistance also, and you know what's the power requirement for the vessel at that speed. I think it's not moving. Some problem, let me check. Some problem with it. It's not going to the next slide. Second. Okay, we have been watching that the one that the rib vessel model test, and now you look to the case of a south vessel. Here, this is another experiment which we carried out. This intention is basically to find out what is the powering requirement. We tried different versions of the and also different configuration of the south vessel. And you can see here in the middle there's a gap. It's actually four hulls, one hull here, another hull here, the same thing on the other side. And you can see the middle portion, there's a gap, so there's a connection. So it has been found that the middle region was creating lot of waves, and when we filled that opening, it was found to improve the flow condition, and finally we suggested such a configuration for this south proposed, and which will obviously reduce the total resistance. So now we see the prediction of model tests, a simple example here how it's done. Resistance, we consider a 2000 lpg cylinder carrier which is done for as a part of a project. These are the main particulars of the vessel and model. You can see this is the length, length between perpendicular, breadth, then the depth, draft, displacement, and the speed. We use the model scale of 1:13, and this is the corresponding model parameters. So what it is, the model, after you make the model, is a procedure here which is adopted. You make the from the drawing of the, that is the lines plan, you find out, you take the template, cut the template from that, that is you get the body plan, and from that you make templates of the required scale, and these templates are laid, and then as per the designated position lengthwise, and then it is covered with wooden strips to get the form, and the form is finally fared, and with application of a different material and all that, and finally from that you make the mold using fiberglass, and this fiberglass mold is used to make the model. So once the model is made with the proper stiffening inside and all that to keep it rigid, and then the model is taken to the tank, and the model is ballasted to get the load condition. That means you have already marked the load water line and also the stations. So the model has to displace till the water line, that is a design load water line. So for that you weigh the model, and you find out what is the difference of weight to be placed on the model, and the model is ballasted, or then it displaces up to the design load water line. So then that is, I think it is shown here, okay, maybe in the next we will see. So model towing tests are conducted in the speed range of over the design speed, that is you start with very low speed for the model, you go in increase it gradually in a discrete model speeds, you measure the resistance, and usually it is done maybe about maybe 10% or 15% more than the service speed of the model. So this, the whole range of speed is covered, and the from the towing test you find out what is the resistance for corresponding resistance for the corresponding speed. Results are obtained by extrapolation on the base of 1978 prediction method using the Froude laws of scaling. So we have already seen that Froude law of scaling, which implies that Froude number of ship is equal to Froude number of the model, from which you get the velocity of model is equal to velocity of ship divided by square root of lambda, that is the scale. So here the calculation of the form factor, what is the first method we have to adopt, that is you know, you have to find out, run the model at very low speed, very low Froude number, and get the form factor. So the, these are the terms used in this analysis, that is a model resistance, RTM, total resistance of the model, then density of fresh water, model speed, surface surface area of the model, length of the model, its waterline length is considered, then viscosity nu, fresh water, acceleration due to gravity, then you have the CRM, that is a residual resistance coefficient of the model. So here the viscosity is taken as, fresh water viscosity is taken as this value for 25 degrees Celsius, and this is the density used. So the total model resistance coefficient, we know, we have already seen that it is coming as a RTM divided by half rho m Sm into Vm square, these are all model parameters used. Reynolds number defined by this relation is is all well known. Then you use IDDC formula to get the CFM, and you know the fruit number is given by these parameters, root number of model, so it will be m by root of g lm, which is same as equal to the fruit number of the ship. So the total resistance now is represented by considering form factor 1 plus k into CFO ohm. CFO m is a flat plate resistance coming from IDDC formula for the model, and then the CRM. So we know this procedure, we have already seen in the Prohaska's method. So you represent that this form, and finally you get the CRM in terms of Fn raised to 4 into, so this you get this expression here. So from this you get what is the parameters Fn raised to 4 by CFOM, and also CTM by CFOM. So you get the columns, then you go for the plot, you plot these values here, then you get the points. Then if it is straight line through the point using regression, so you get a straight line, and finally the intersection here, that will give the form factor. So that is the Prohaska's method adopted. Now extrapolation of the method to prototype, what you have done is for the model. So how you extrapolate this? So the just go through the symbols, what you use, scale is a model scale use, RTS is a resistance of the total resistance of the ship, RTM is the total resistance of the model. So this is the speed of the ship, speed of the model based on the Froude law, then wetter surface area of ship and model, then fresh water density and seawater density and fresh water density. So there is, so other things, coefficients, all these are self explanatory. Again, what is that resistance coefficient of the, it's a total the CT of this CTS, then you have the CTM, that's the model, CRM, CRS, and all the coefficients here, then length, kinematic viscosity, and the form factor definition. The physical constants used for seawater, the density is taken as 1025 kilograms per meter cube, and freshwater density is taken as this one. Viscosity is seawater at 25 degrees given by this quantity, and that in fresh water given by this one. So now what you do is you have RTS is equal to CTS into half rho S of rho S into V square into S. So you get then CTS is equal to this distance, I mean CTS is equal to CFOS plus CRS plus the correlation elements. So from this you get CRS is equal to CTM minus CFOM, and that is obtained. CFOM is coming from this expression, and CA is used, this is the value for CA used. Then you have all these parameters are known. So finally you get CRM is equal to CTM minus CFOM, and all these quantities coming from that of the CFOM of the model, CFO of the ship, and Reynolds number estimated, and finally you have the quantities here, the model, and so you have, this is tested for a draft of 2.3 meters and hull fitted with all appendages, and it's the even keel position, no trim considered. So these are the values, and this one what is shown in the yellow color, that is for the survey speed of 11 knots. So then it's plotted, you get the resistance against the speed, you get the resistance curve, and then you have the RT into V, that gives effective power. So you plot effective power against the speed of the ship. So this is effective power of the ship. Now the tests have been repeated for another draft for 2.5 meter. So this value is plotted here, and this what is shown here, this is for the 2.5 meter higher draft, and this is for the lower draft. So this test may be required when the case when the ship is immersing more, or maybe a ship is designed to have more displacement, and when it operates what is the power requirement and what would be the speed it can achieve. So this is the same thing for the effective power RT into V for different to the two drafts. Okay, with this this covers the total deep water resistance cases, what we have discussed so far. We have seen what are the, how the model, the ship resistance is predicted using model test, what are the steps involved in that, what are the similarities required, that is you have, we have to have the geometrical similarity, kinematical similarity and dynamical similarity. So all these similarities are required to predict it, but we have seen that it is difficult to meet the kinematical similarity because the Reynolds number, which is a representation of the kinematics, are not going to be same for ship and model due to practical reasons. We have already said, so it is difficult to. So what you do is Reynolds, the frictional force is estimated using the values obtained from flat plate resistance test done for by different agencies. We have seen the formula like Schoner formula, Hughes formula, ITTC formula. We have seen different formula to find out the CF value, that is a frictional resistance. Why it is done? Because it is not possible to find out the frictional resistance from the model test. Why it is not possible? Because the kinematical conditions are not similar. Why it is, they are not similar? These two cases, the ship and model are not operating at the same Reynolds number. When the Reynolds number or numbers are not same, then naturally the flow condition close to the ship or the boundary layer of the ship will be different. So where the model you have the Reynolds number low, which operates in the laminar condition, and whereas the ship the Reynolds number is high and the boundary layer is going to be turbulent one. So the flow kinematics are different, the water particle motion inside the laminar boundary layer in model and inside the turbulent boundary layer in ship are, they are different. So the kinematical similarity is not met between ship and model, hence the prediction of frictional resistance is not possible from the model test for the ship. So that is why the problem, total problem of resistance has been divided into two. One is the frictional resistance component, the total resistance is a frictional resistance, plus the other components we call the residuary resistance component, of which the wave making resistance is a major one. Another similarity condition is the dynamical similarity condition. The dynamical similarity condition is referring to the forces or pressures, and which is coming from, which is represented by the Froude number, because the gravitational, the ratio of inertia force to gravitational forces, that is a Froude number. So the Froude number refers to the free surface waves. So it is easy to satisfy the Froude number between ship and model, provided you operate the model at a speed equal to that of the ship divided by square root of the scale. So if you model, then you can satisfy that. So that is why the models operate at lower speed compared to that of the ship. So from this you will be able to find out the residuary resistance coefficient, and since it is satisfying the Froude number, the residual resistance coefficient between the ship and model are same. So you choose the value, the residual resistance coefficient from the model, and that is put for the ship resistance estimation. And later we have seen the form effect not considered in the flat plate, so you have to consider the form effect, and we have seen the Prakaskas method and also the run-in point and the things like that, which will account from which we will be able to estimate the form factor from the model, and the same form factor is used for the ship. And from using that model you are considering whole viscous effect including friction and the form effect. So that effect is included in the prediction of the ship resistance, and that is what you have seen in the 1978 ITTC method when compared with the 1957 ITTC method. That difference is the, this a form factor influence is the major one. And generally the resistance tests are done, which will give not only the information about resistance and powering, it also gives information about the flow condition around the model, which will go as an input into the alteration of the design if required. So these are the general things what you have. All these things are done only for deep water condition, but you know that in actual life for the ship may encounter shallow water, it may have to, it has to go through shallow water region, and also there are vessels which are designed exclusively for shallow water operation like inland water vessels and all that. So next we will see how the waterway restriction is influencing the resistance of the ship, which we will take up in the next class.